A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th July, on the front page you have two more Congress MLAs quit in Karnataka. So this is regarding the crisis in Karnataka. The Congress JDS government has been formed, the coalition government has been formed, but now Congress MLAs are quitting, and here you can see 10 Congress MLAs joined BJP in Goa too. So BJP was the single largest party, but Congress JDS came together and formed the government. And now BJP wants to assert power here, and MLAs are being poached, it is evident, and they have joined Congress MLAs. So they have actually resigned, means those seats become vacant. So the strength of the house goes less and BJP can get its majority. Also, for these seats, by-elections would be held, and BJP feels that it would easily win those by-elections. Below you have Worker Safety Code Bill gets cabinet approval. So this is regarding a bill that seeks to merge 13 labor laws into one code on occupational safety, health and working conditions. So that would apply to all establishments with 10 or more workers. So this has been approved by the Union Cabinet and has been introduced in the legislature now. So this is the code on occupational safety and health and working conditions bill of 2019, and this would be the second of the four proposed codes. So there are 44 labor laws which need to be merged, so they will be merged into four codes. So this is the second one. The first one here is mentioned, you can see that is code on wages bill 2019, that has been approved by the cabinet. So that is the first of the codes, and this is the second one. Then on page 3 you have government fails to comply with NCT order, faces forfeits rupees 5 crore. So this is the National Green Tribunal that had directed performance guarantee of over 5 crore to be deposited by Delhi government. Now it has been forfeited because the government failed to comply with the orders on two separate matters pertaining to pollution caused by dairies and illegal banquet halls in the city. So the government did not enforce green norms on illegal banquet halls and eateries, and now its 5 crore has been forfeited. Then below you have advanced timeline for waste to energy plant. So National Green Tribunal order has come on plea alleging unscientific dumping of garbage in Sonipat. So now the National Green Tribunal has directed, Sonipat is in Haryana, so the Haryana Chief Secretary has been asked to advance the timeline, means bring ahead the timeline for establishment of waste to energy plants. So this is here. On page 8 you have Hindustan Shipyard Limited in race for Navy submarine project. So the public sector undertaking, it says, along with two other public sector consortium partners, it is gearing up to submit its bid for the construction of 6 conventional submarines, for which expression of interest notification has been issued by the Indian Navy. So this will be followed by another EOI for original equipment manufacturers. So this is under Make in India, means there will be original equipment manufacturers and Indian consortium who would be working together with them. So this, the Indian strategic partner has to design and construct the submarines in the country under Make in India initiative. So for which this is called Project 75I. So this, for this, even Hindustan Shipyard Limited has submitted its bid. On page 9 you have Bengal port records country's highest sea level rise in 50 years. So 4 ports in India have recorded a higher sea level rise than the global average. So one of them is the Diamond Harbour in West Bengal. So it's located at the mouth of River Hooghly and has recorded a maximum sea level increase according to data tabled in the Lok Sabha by the Minister of Earth Science. So here you can see that it is estimated that 1.33 millimeter per year has been the rise in the sea level along India's coast during last 40 to 50 years. But at Diamond Harbour, the rise was almost 5 times higher at 5.16 millimeter per year. Then this is single tribunal to hear water disputes. So Interstate Water Disputes Tribunal bill has been proposed, which seeks to resolve conflicts under a single tribunal, and also these conflicts should be resolved within 18 months. So this is a bill tabled, which has been approved by the Union Cabinet and will be tabled now. Then other key decisions in the parliament are mentioned here. There is a bill to tackle bonsai scams. The green light has been given to rural roads, the third phase of Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. And then RPF, Railway Protection Force. For this, the Union Cabinet has accorded organized Group A service status. and death penalty for child abuse. So this is also an amendment to the Protection of Child from Sexual Offences Act of 2012. This is sought to be amended by this bill, which seeks death penalty for child abuse. And then there is a bill for Transgender Persons Protection of Rights Bill 2019. The previous version had lapsed in the Lok Sabha. So this bill looks at providing social, economic and educational empowerment to transgender persons. Then this is Indian Air Force to adopt ASRAM, SRAM, that is Advanced Short Range Air-to-Air Missile for fighter fleet. So currently it is undergoing integration. So this is the new European Visual Range Air-to-Air Missile, which will be adopted across its fighter fleet by the Indian Air Force. On the editorial page, the first editorial is caution needed. So the Supreme Court's decision on Rohingya status, which is going to come forth now because the government has put forth this question whether illegal migrants are entitled to refugee status. So Supreme Court is going to look into this matter, and the editorial says that the decision of the Supreme Court on this Rohingya status must protect those fleeing persecution. And second editorial, Grecian Church. So this is regarding Greece. So the government which came to power in Greece is set for a period of stability and continuity now, because Greece is one of the countries in Europe which have been undergoing crisis, economic crisis. And here you can see the government has been formed in Greece now by the conservative center-right New Democracy Party. Then the lead article is A Demographic Window of Opportunity. So this says that in India, investing in the laggard states will ensure their role as being the greatest contributors of the future. So the states which are lagging behind, they have a huge population, and if investment is done there, then they would be giving the demographic dividends in the future. So that's an article on that. And this is Turning Down the Heat. So it says there's enormous potential in mitigating climate change through forest restoration. So if forest restoration takes place, green cover is enhanced, the mitigating climate change is easily possible. So there is enormous potential there. Then on the op-ed page here, this is an article on Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of the country, and on Kashmir, because Union Home Minister Amit Shah has made a statement that it was Prime Minister Narendra Modi because of whom 1/3 of Kashmir was lost by India. So this article talks of how the former Prime Minister had made a mistake, but that was only that he had too much confidence in the sense of justice of his successors. So he felt that justice would prevail. He approached the United Nations Security Council too, but the justice was not provided and Pakistan was supported. Then this is deepening #MeToo. So a year after an actor inspired women to speak up against harassment, it is critical to assess the gains and challenges now. So this article talks of #MeToo. You should know about this. And this is a case for nutrition counseling. So it says it is a low cost measure that offers lifelong benefits. So Integrated Child Development Scheme is one of the largest schemes in the world for early childhood care and development. And now it says a new study suggests that nutrition and health counseling delivered under the programs is one of the best possible investments that can be made by any government. On page 12, you have India can repeal Article 370 at will. So the center says that Article 370 of the Constitution of India, which gives special status to Jammu and Kashmir, this can be repealed by India at any time. No country or the UN has any say in this matter. Then this is banks delaying Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana urban subsidies. So this has been admitted by the government in the Rajya Sabha. So there have been complaints received of banks either not sanctioning or delaying disbursement to applicants of credit linked subsidy scheme under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana urban. Then on page 13, you have NATO ally status unlikely now. So this is regarding a bill which will be passed in USA. So this is National Defense Authorization Act of 2020 of USA, for which an amendment bill, that is New India NDA amendment, which has now been passed by the voted by the US House Committee on Rules and will be sent to the full House floor for voting. So this new India NDA amendment is actually a watered down version of an amendment earlier, which is known as Sherman Amendment, that sought to place India on par with US NATO allies. So that, I mean, Sherman Amendment sought to amend even the Arms Export Control Act of USA, which is a US law that governs the sale of high-end defense equipments to other countries. But now that has been, that is not going to go ahead, and now a watered down version will be passed. So NATO ally status unlikely for India now. And this is tariff tensions top US agenda in meetings today. So US trade representative team is going to meet officials on Indian side, and issues will be discussed between India and USA, the trade related issues like withdrawal of preferential trade status, India's preferential trade status in March. So even general system of preferences was GSP was withdrawn for India by USA. So all these issues will be discussed at this meet. Then on international page you have British envoy resigns after Trump leak. So US President Donald Trump had called British ambassador to USA as stupid. So and termed the administration inept, and now the British envoy has resigned. On business page you have GDP growth rates in economic survey budget consistent with each other, says the finance minister. So the two use different base figures, but the figures are consistent. And this is Central Statistical Organization must rethink informal sector estimates. So this is stated that current method is no longer accurate due to greater automation. So the former chief statistician of India, Pranab Sen, says that informal sector estimates should be rethought. Then on page 16 you have industry jittery as auto sales slide continues. So this reduction in sale of automobiles, that is passenger cars, utility vehicles, all have the growth rate is in the negative for all. So this is a cause of concern now for the industry, the automobile industry. Then on the last page here you have 300 member all-women voyage to fight ocean plastic. So the researchers here will focus on finding tailored solutions. So this will be round the world voyage launched in October 2019 to highlight the devastating impact of plastic pollution in the oceans and conduct scientific research into the escalating crisis. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asia.com. Thank you.